In this video, we will try to understand how to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of simply supported beam carrying uniformly distributed load throughout the span and a point load as shown over here. Now the total span length is L is equal to 6 meter and a point load of 2 kN is acting at a distance of 4 meter from the left hand support, and there is a u.d.l of 1.5 kN per meter acting over the entire span length. Now, first we'll convert this uniformly distributed load into a point load. Now, the meaning of 1.5 kN per meter is for 1 meter length, the load that is acting is 1.5 kN. Now, this total length on which this UDL is acting is 6 meter. So, as it is acting on the entire length, we can say that if for 1 meter length the load is 1.5 kN, then for 6 meter length it will be 1.5 into 6, that is 9 kN. And as it is a rectangular distribution, that particular 9 kN load will act at the center. So first we'll convert that uniformly distributed load into a point load of 9 kN acting at a distance of 3 meter, that is half of this particular 6 meter length, that is 3 meter as shown over here. So now we'll find out these reactions Ra and Rb. The first condition of equilibrium is summation of forces in y direction is equal to 0. Upward forces, they are considered as positive, and downward forces, they are considered as negative. So Ra and Rb, they are acting in the upward direction, so they are positive. This 9 kN and this 2 kN load, they are acting in the downward direction, so they are negative. So it is Ra plus Rb is equal to 11 kN. Now we'll take summation of moments is equal to 0, clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. Now we'll take moment about this point A. So this Rb, the arrow of this Rb will go in the anti-clockwise direction towards A. So as it is anti-clockwise, it is negative, and from P up to A, the perpendicular distance is 6. So it is minus Rb into 6. This 2 kN, the arrow of this 2 kN is going in the clockwise direction towards A. So it is 2 into 4. Then this 9 kN, it is also producing clockwise moment, and the perpendicular distance from this point up to A is 3. So it is 9 into 3 is equal to 0. Now transfer this negative term, that is minus Rb into 6, on the other side, so it will become 6 Rb. Then 2 into 4, that is 8, plus 9 into 3, that is 27. So total will be 35. So we can say that Rb is equal to 35 divided by 6, that is 5.833 kN. Now substitute this value of Rb in equation 1. So from equation 1, we can say that Ra is nothing but 11 minus Rb. So it is 11 minus 5.8333. So it is 5.167 kN. So these are the values of Ra and Rb. Now we have to draw the shear force diagram. So conventions which we have used for simply supported beam, upward forces, they are considered as positive, whereas downward forces, they are considered as negative. Now we'll start from the left hand support, that is A. So shear force at A is equal to 5.167 kN acting in the upward direction, so it is positive. Now shear force at C left means we are not considering this 2 kN load. We are considering all the other forces which are acting on the left hand side of C. So we'll start with Ra, that is 5.167 positive because it is acting in the upward direction. And the UDL from A up to just left of C, that is 1.5 into 4, that is 6. So that will be minus 0.833 kN. Then shear force exactly at point C will be to this minus 0.833. This 2 kN which is acting in the downward direction will get added. So it is minus 2.8333 kN. Similarly, shear force at left of the B, we have to take into consideration only this particular UDL which is acting between C and B. So it is 1.5 into 2 that will get added to this previous calculated value of minus 2.8333 kN. So it is minus 5.8333 kN. Exactly at B, this point load or reaction up which is acting in the upward direction, that will get added. So it is minus 5.833 plus 5.8333 kN, that is 0 kN. So using these values, we can draw the shear force diagram. So shear force at A, shear force at C left, exactly at C, then B left, and then at B. And the various values, they are also shown over here. Now this shear force diagram, it changes the sign from positive to negative at this section. And we have to find out, this is the point of zero shear where the bending moment will be maximum. So that point we have to find out. So we'll consider only that particular section. Suppose it is acting at a distance of x from the left hand support A, as shown over here. So we have to find out now the point of zero shear. So we'll consider all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of this particular section. So RA is acting in the upward direction, that is 5.167. Then UDL is acting, UDL of 1.5 kilonewton per meter is acting for x meter length. So it is 1.5 into x. But the shear force at this particular section is zero. So equate this particular left hand side equal to zero. Transfer this negative 1.5x term on the left hand side, so it will become positive, and x will be equal to 5.167 divided by 1.5, that is 3.444 meter from A. Now at this particular section, we'll find out the maximum bending moment also. So first we'll convert this UDL into point load, so 1.5 into x, and it will be acting at the center of x, that is x by 2, so that we can take moment about this section xx, which is maximum bending moment. The conventions used, they are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative for the bending moment. So consider all the forces on the left hand side of xx. So RA, which is acting in the upward direction, so it will produce clockwise moment about this xx, so it is 5.167 into x. Now this 1.5 into x, this will produce anti-clockwise moment about xx, so 1.5 into x, and the perpendicular distance is x by 2. So that also we have written over here. Now substitute the value of x. X is nothing but 3.4444. So that value you can substitute over here. This x into x is x square. So substituting the value of x at these places, we will get the bending moment at section xx as 8.899 kilonewton meter, and this will be the maximum bending moment over here. Now using these values, we can easily draw the bending moment diagram. So first we'll convert this UDL of 1.5 kilonewton per meter between A and C, the distance is 4, so 1.5 into 4, so that will be the 6 kilonewton load acting at a center of 4 meter, that is 2 meter. Section xx, where the bending moment we have already calculated. So now we'll start with the remaining bending moments. So bending moment at the ends, they are zero. So bending moment at A will be zero. Similarly, bending moment at B will also be zero. So first we'll calculate bending moment at point C. Xx we have already calculated, so it is 8.899. Then after this section xx, the point is C. So we'll calculate bending moment at this particular point C. So consider all the forces on the left hand side of C, except this particular 2 kilonewton. It will not have any moment about C. So RA, upward acting reaction RA, will produce clockwise moment. So arrow of this RA will go in the clockwise direction about C. So it is, and the perpendicular distance is 4 meter between A and C. So it is 5.167 into 4. Then this point load, the UDL which we have converted into point load, that is 6 kilonewton, will produce anti-clockwise moment about C, and the perpendicular distance is 2. So the bending moment at C comes out to be 8.668 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at point B will be 0. So using these values, we can easily draw the bending moment diagram. So as you can see over here, the bending moment at the section xx is maximum of 8.899 kilonewton meter. Then at C it is 8.668, and at the ends it is 0. So the beam will get bent in this particular fashion, that is indicated by this bending moment diagram. Thank you very much for watching.